Analyze in Excel is one of the coolest and valuable Power BI features, which lets you connect an Excel pivot table to a Power BI data model. But this is where implicit and explicit measures work quite differently. Let me show you why that is important. Keep watching. To show you the next key difference between implicit and explicit measures, I have to go a little bit deeper. So stay with me here. What I have on the left is a model which is using implicit measures. That means that I have simply, dragged and dropped fields from my table, an existing column. I just dropped it here, and then I chose the sum summarization. I did the same with budget amount. I didn't explicitly define any measures. This is being summed, and I could change that. So that's an implicit measure. And on the right, I'm using explicit measures. So this is, I've defined a measure in sales. You can see I've used the definition here. Same thing with budget. Now, what you would notice is that they both return the exact same results. They look alike, but I want to take you to this visual. So think about the purpose is not so you can use this model. The purpose is so that you can publish it, and this becomes a single source of truth for all reporting. And you want users or yourself later on to be able to connect to it using a tool of their choice. And I don't know about you, but one of my favorite tools is right here. And that's what I want to talk about, that how it differs when you have implicit versus explicit measures. So I'm going to speed this part up, but what I'm doing essentially is I'm uploading both models to PowerBI.com. I'm publishing them, and then we're going to see how it impacts when you connect using Excel. All right, so we have both models uploaded there. I have the implicit model and I have the explicit model. And of course, you can create a Power BI reports on here. But remember, we want to be able to connect perhaps different tools, and certainly Excel is one of them. So that's what I want to zero in on. So what we're going to do is first try the explicit one, and we're going to go in there and say analyze in Excel. All right, so it's going to ask me to save this file. Open it. So it gives me a pivot table connected to the data model in the cloud, right? So that's what Analyze in Excel gives me. And I should be able to create a report here. Now, I have all the field lists available here. There is one difference. If you would notice that my measures are bubbled up top. So budget and sales measures are bubbled up top. Now, the tables are still down below. So all the column attributes, budget, calendar, customer, and if you keep going down, there's product and there's sales. So all of that stuff is there, but the measures are up top, which actually I kind of like. I love my measures. Give me my measures. Well, yeah, all right. So we can build something like this. Let's make it giant, shall we? And we can slice and dice it any which way we want. So we can say, hey, maybe show that to me by category and subcategory. So you get the idea, and this becomes my report, which is connected to that. All right, so what we're doing again is that we're trying to have our one source of truth, and we're trying to create Excel reports connected off of that. Now, what if we had not defined those measures explicitly, right? So we had the other data set, which we had just used implicit measures, which are really, you dragging on a column and choosing how is it summarized. It's sum, is it average, and so forth. So that was our first model. And now let's try the same thing with that. So we're gonna say click Analyze in Excel. All right, open that, and perfect. We get a pivot table connected to our model, woohoo! But wait, something seems off. Okay, so we didn't have any measures, so they didn't bubble to the top. That makes sense. No big deal. I should be able to just grab my sales and budget amount and just drag it in there, right? So yeah, I'm gonna grab my sales amount column and I'm just gonna put in the values. Oh wait, it's not letting me. Oh no, bummer. What about budget amount? Maybe that'll be cooperative. Budget amount, no dime. So this is, gosh, a little bit long term. So right now, maybe you're not going to be concerned about this. Maybe you're not thinking about this. But my friend, you have to have that vision. You're not just building this model for yourself. You're building it so that it can become the one source of truth, and later you can connect any and every report to it. Power BI dashboard report or Excel. So because this one scenario is severely hampered, if you do not have explicitly defined measures and later you connect an Excel file to your Power BI published model, there's really nothing you can do. There's no math you can do. I mean, you can list out the budget amount, but gosh, that's not what I want to do. I want to be able to use my measures and slice and dice it. So I'll rest my case there. I hope I have convinced you. I'm certainly pretty passionate about this and certainly would encourage you. Hey, just do the right thing. Just define your measures rather than dragging columns and using the inbuilt summarization in Power BI Desktop. It's going to be good in the long run when you connect eventually Excel reports to it, but it's also good in the short run because it helps to reuse measures, as you'll see as well, and gives you more control over the measures. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.